As of December 14th of 2025, there are currently 45 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one more than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes is Nicaragua's Masaya Volcano, which long ago was searched by conquistadors who incorrectly thought that gold lay buried within its active lava lake. While they, of course, did not find any gold, it is a reminder that this volcano has maintained an active lava lake for much of the last 500 years at a minimum. While its current eruption is almost completely effusive, the presence of a caldera indicates that thousands of years ago, Masaya produced far more powerful and explosive eruptions. And now, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In the Philippines, the infamous Mayon volcano has erupted anew. But wait, you might say, if you live near Mayon, you won't see any orange glow from lava or green rising volcanic ash. And you'd be correct. Regardless, Mayon really is erupting, just in a somewhat localized manner. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, the alert level of the Talang volcano was raised due to a strong storm of earthquakes for this particular volcanic complex, carrying with it a new 2-kilometer exclusion zone. And, in what is this week's top story, the Ambae volcano erupted anew in Vanuatu for the first time of 2025, creating an eruption plume easily visible from satellite that drifted a whopping 200 kilometers to the northeast on December 8th. While it is still unclear exactly how much volcanic material erupted during the creation of the 13,000-foot, nearly 4,000-meter-high plume, preliminary data shows that a fairly sizable area was coated in thick volcanic ash, specifically at least across this 36.5-square-kilometer area. It is unknown if any pyroclastic flows were generated that climbed beyond the summit caldera walls, but I wouldn't be surprised if we later learned that this happened. There are not yet any on-the-ground photos of the eruption aftermath at this shield volcano, and very few people live where even trace ash fell. Yet, this eruption began all the way back on November 30th. Initial eruptive activity was moderately explosive, as while Ambae is a shield volcano, any time magma, regardless of composition, interacts with lake water, it will generate explosive activity. This is why a tuff cone has grown in its second largest lake during the last decade. Initial eruption plumes did not rise more than a few thousand feet above Ambae's summit, but then, on December 7th, I interpret that some lava was extruded as indicated by these heat signatures. This may have formed a plug that caused pressure to build underneath it before finally being released via a larger eruption the following day. This sequence could have represented the volcano's largest eruption since 2018. More eruptive activity could occur soon, but there is also a decent chance that the sheer volume of magma expelled on December 8th could mean the eruption is over. Meanwhile, in the Philippines, 14 kilometers north-northwest of Legazpi City, the picturesque Mount Mayon volcano is erupting lava for the first time since 2023, and the proof is right here. Okay, that isn't helpful. Let's zoom in further. The darker patches you see are new lava that has erupted sometime in the last week, forming small basaltic lava spines. This new lava appears to have been emplaced on the south-southeast portion of Mayon's summit. However, while five oaks stand that this is new lava, I caution that it might instead be old 2023 lava being pushed upwards by increased pressure in the magma conduit like we saw before the 2023 eruption began. Regardless of which is the case, Mayon could be the site of actual orange glows and ash plumes rising from its summit in portions of the next few months. And in Indonesia, the alert level of the Talang volcano on Sumatra was raised from green to yellow on December 10th. While volcanic earthquakes had been increasing underneath its summit since September 2024, they did not truly begin to reach high levels until the last week. On one particular day, for example, more than 100 volcanic earthquakes struck. Magma is now presumably at 2 to 3 kilometers depth below Talang's summit, and since many of these earthquakes seem to indicate increased pressurization, there is an increased chance of a phreatic eruption occurring. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on December 13th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel members and patrons on Patreon for supporting my work.